Our next panelist is Ms. Bonnie Castillo. Ms. Castillo is a registered nurse and the executive director of the National Nurses United and of the California Nurses Association National Nurses Organizing Committee. NNU is the largest union and professional association of registered nurses in the United States, representing more than 175,000 nurses. And I just want to take this opportunity to thank all of the nurses in this country and the doctors as well. We have lost thousands, I think, as we all know. I heard this morning at least 5,000 nurses have died in this pandemic alone. These are the real heroes and heroines of our time, and we thank them very much. Ms. Castillo, thanks very much for being with us.
Thank you. Thank you. And good morning, and thank you, Chairman Sanders, Ranking Member Graham, and members of the committee for holding this critically important hearing today. As a registered nurse and executive director of the nation's largest union of RNs, I can think of nothing more fitting to commemorate International Nurses Day today than by advocating for the urgent transition to a Medicare for All system. For more than 2 years, nurses across the country have worked on the front lines of the COVID pandemic. We have cared for patients despite atrocious working conditions that put nurses and our families at risk. If it was ever in doubt before, this pandemic has shown that our current profit-driven and fragmented healthcare system does not work. It does not provide quality therapeutic care to millions of Americans. It does not value and protect its own healthcare workers, and it is unable to provide a comprehensive pandemic response. Why didn't nurses and healthcare workers get the protections we needed in the pandemic? It was because our employers value money over our lives. Why didn't we have the emergency stocks of critical medical supplies that we needed? Because the healthcare industry makes their supply chains based on maximizing profit, not safeguarding patient care. We have seen high death rates from COVID across the country. Why? Because there are tens of millions of people in the country who are uninsured or underinsured and who therefore do not get the preventive care they need, putting them at much higher risk for severe COVID illness, hospitalization, and death. But the problems with our healthcare system far predate this pandemic. For years, nurses have witnessed the tragedies that result from a profit-driven healthcare system. Nurses watch so many patients forego needed care because they can't afford the cost. They watch as insurance companies deny life-saving care, overriding the professional judgment of nurses and other medical professionals. Nurses watch as patients come to the emergency room with advanced stages of illness or disease that could have been avoided if they had had access to preventive care. The system we have now is beholden to the corporate interests that determine who gets treatment and when they get it. The United States spends more money per capita on healthcare than any other nation in the world, and yet we have the worst health outcomes when compared to other wealthy countries. This system is unaffordable for our country and for our patients, and the pandemic has shown that our society cannot afford the public health consequences. The only way to solve the healthcare crisis is to enact a single-payer Medicare for All system. Under Medicare for All, every person living in the United States would get a quality therapeutic healthcare regardless of the ability to pay. We would transform the profit-driven health insurance system into one that actually prioritizes patient care. As a registered nurse, I can envision exactly what Medicare for All would mean for patients. Whenever someone needs medical care, they would see the healthcare provider of their choice without any worry about financial barriers to care. We would no longer see patients suffer because they can't afford care. Patients would no longer have to actually ration their medications. For healthcare workers, we would be able to provide medical and nursing care based on our professional judgment without the interference of insurance companies. The Medicare for All Act would allow for tangible, practical improvements to the healthcare delivery, and importantly, it would change the way that hospitals are paid, fundamentally shifting their profit motives so that they prioritize patient care and worker health and safety instead. By paying hospitals through global budgets, the bill would ensure that hospitals have the funding necessary for safe nurse-to-patient staffing ratios, pandemic preparedness, and occupational safety and health programs. The programs would ensure that hospitals in rural and underserved areas always get the funding they need to stay open. And it's designed to address healthcare inequities at their core by changing the systems that limit healthcare for low-income communities and particularly for communities of color. As registered nurses, our primary responsibility is to protect the health and well-being of our patients. Our existing healthcare system does not allow us to do that. Medicare for All is the solution we need to ensure that every patient gets the healthcare they need. Thank you.
Ms. Castillo, thank you very much.